Liberals call for trees to be destroyed. Because trees are racist. A row of trees has become the left's latest target in a fight against racism and segregation. Tall tamarisk trees grow between residents living on a portion of the Lawrence Crossley neighborhood in Palm Springs, California, and the Tockwitz Creek Golf Course in San Jacinto Mountains. The trees block the view of the course and the mountains from the residents, and those residents claim the trees negatively impact the value of their homes because they separate them from the golf course. Residents told the Palm Springs Desert Sun in an article published in September that the trees are a symbol of racism and inequality, and they wanted them to come down. The Sun report said the row of trees, which is on property owned by the city, was planted in the 1960s to block off the historically black neighborhood from wealthy white patrons using the golf course on the other side. The Sun on Monday reported that after an informal meeting with neighborhood residents on Sunday, Palm Springs Mayor Robert Moon, along with other city officials, promised residents that the trees would come down. Councilmember J.R. Roberts apologized to residents and added that he and the rest of the council members wanted to ensure that future residents would not have the same problems that current residents have. City Manager David Reddy told The Sun that the tree removal would not happen immediately as the city council still needed to approve the matter. But there is little doubt that the measure will be approved. Reddy said the project could cost the city as much as $169,000, and trees could come down within 3 months. Real estate agent Tri Daniel, who is white, led the movement to have the trees removed. "It's really about the barriers. It's about the segregation and discrimination that has prevented black people in Palm Springs from accumulating wealth," Daniel told The Sun. "That's a stretch. Golf courses are designed to be enclosed areas, sheltering players from the workaday world, and protecting the outside world from stray golf balls that could be dangerous. Trees and other natural barriers are part of golf courses the world over, regardless of the race of their neighbors. But liberals love to stretch the truth, and if that means calling a stand of trees racist, then trees are racist." Residents have also made other demands of the city, which include a 6-foot privacy wall for residents who want one, installing netting to prevent stray golf balls from flying into residents' yards, and planting new trees similar to those on other parts of the course, The Sun reported. "The angst created by this row of trees, which has stood for decades, is just another example of liberal lunacy gone wild. It appears that there is nothing safe from being called racist. The possibilities of where this kind of thinking could go is frightening because if a row of trees on a golf course means racism, then we are headed for trouble.